everybody. It's Pete from 619 Muscle. We're about to blast some shoulders, less than 2 weeks out from my pro debut, Phoenix Pro. And we have a treat for us today. Big Jon Ward, just off his top five at USA, top five at North Americans. He did really good this year. He's had a great year. All right, let's get to it. We'll see you guys in the weight room. Pro last year, Master Nationals, 198 pounds on stage, probably a little bit heavier. But you know, for the past 7 years, I've been a light heavyweight, and I've been working my way down for about the past five of the past seven, trying to make weight. And the more I continue to train and continue to train over the past 5 years, the more that I felt like my body has wanted to fill out, and the more that having to come down year after year for light heavyweights, you know, as anyone who's done that type of journey knows. You know, you limit your growth. As soon as I turned pro, I talked to my coach, Don Long, who's been amazing, super smart guy and very supportive. And we picked this show. You know, we had a hope that it would give me enough time to have a real good off season, which I hadn't had in 7 years, and put on just a little bit more fullness, a little more roundness. I competed, as I said, I made weight at 198 last year, and this year, right now, I'm 207. 208 depending. So I'm a good 6, 7, 8, 9 pounds heavier. Once everything is said and done next week, I'll probably be about 5, 6 pounds heavier. God willing, in the right places. You know, we've worked hard to bring my shoulders and my upper body up and keep everything else more proportion, make my midsection look tighter and tinier. Me is about feel and volume for shoulders, not as much weight and heaviness. Although it's still going to go heavy. The volume, volume, volume. Stretch the fascia, stretch the muscle. I'm just training with this big guy. It's been a while. Do one arm at a time, seated. Yeah, these are fun. I'll keep the weight a little bit lighter so it's more volume. I'll be like 15, 15, 12, 12, 9, 9. And then we need the call. Key on this for medial head of the delt. Just stay nice and tall. These are really hard when you're low carb. Stop complaining. Ruh. time picking the Phoenix Pro. I used to live in Phoenix. It's only a short ride from San Diego. I love the town. It's nice and dry. Don't have any problem holding water. I won Arizona State Championship MPC in 99. So it's kind of a coming home of sorts for me, having lived there for several years. The valley is beautiful. I love Phoenix. And it's the last 212 of the year here in the United States. So it's perfect fit for me. We'll see who shows up. I know, you know, I just heard recently that there's going to be some big names there potentially, which will be a tremendous honor for me to stand on stage with some of the best guys in the industry. They're coming over. They're thinking it's going to be an easy game, maybe. But I'm ready. I feel great. I'm in great condition. Coach Don has been really good in helping me dial it in, so I'm very confident in my condition. I've been practicing my posing. I've been working on all the details. I'm going to present, you know, everybody always says that, but unless something really screws up, I'm going to present the best package this show that I've ever had on stage as a bodybuilder, my first pro show. I'm super excited. I didn't have to struggle to make weight at all. As I said, I'm 207, 208 in the mornings these days. With a week to go, I've got probably 3-4 more pounds to go. I'll be a nice heavy 204 before we start putting food back in, pulling out the water. So it's going to be fun. It's been a real busy off season, a great training off season. I've been, knock on wood, fairly injury free. I feel honestly healthier, better, more rested, more recovered than I can remember as a competitive athlete. You know, I'm 45 years old this year, but the lifestyle, honestly, if you do it right and you're smart about it, I feel younger than ever. I feel better than ever. Joints are good, knock on wood. Skin is good. Energy's been great this year. I've been really blessed with some real supportive people. My wife, of course, Marisa de Guzman, Ciccone, IFBB Pro, who's always got me, my back's in my corner all the time, no matter what, even if she's yelling at me. My training partner, Derek Farnsworth, I've been training with him for almost 30 years. He, of course, is going to miss this show, which it's okay. He's pursuing happiness in other parts of the world, which I wish him the best. And the rest of the 619 Muscle family, my clients and my friends and family, Todd behind the microphone and in the camera, of course. You know, bodybuilding is just a tremendous experience all the way around. It's an ongoing, continuous, incremental pursuit of perfection, your own perfection. Of course, it's unattainable. You never get there. But if you're always working towards that goal, you know, it's pretty neat to think that even if you fall short, you're going in the right direction. You know, bodybuilding is amazing. It's a beautiful lifestyle, and I'll never stop doing it, competing or not. You know, bodybuilding is just, that's a way of life. And I think more people should do it. Anyway, you guys, we'll see you in Phoenix, week and a half. No matter who comes in, they better be at their best game, because I'm sure going to be, knock on wood, at my best game. And God willing, it's going to be a favorable outcome. And I've had a real good journey. We'll see you guys there. 8 is the goal. 8 is the goal. Oh, yeah. Helps to have a good spotter. Thanks, John.
Super heavyweight, man. My boy, Big Eddie.
What's up, guys?
Now, I know Big Eddie's getting ready for Nationals. So you just saw him sneaking through after doing his cardio.
Yep.
I want to give a shout out.
Thanks, man.
Feel good?
I feel great, man. About 5 weeks away now for me.
Yeah.
2 weeks for Big Pete and pro debut. He's going to do great, man. I'm really proud of him. And he knows his stuff, man. He's taught me a lot, and I'm more than grateful.
Oh, yeah. And we got the crew here, the big men. Inspiration to me. Very proud of these guys. Got some good stuff going on. But now I gotta get back to shoulder training.
Let's do it. All right.
Good to see you, my man.
Yeah, see you. Yeah.
Cross the body, rear delts. A little better stretch, a little better range of motion. The thing about shoulders that I learned, you know, shoulders are always a weak point for me.
throughout my whole career. Chest was always strong, quads were strong, and shoulders and arms kind of faded by the wayside. But I realized you train them too heavy, same thing with arms. For me, what ends up happening is you lose a feel. You lose a feel, you lose a connection, you lose the connection to the muscle. It don't grow, something else is training. So, you know, after 2009, I had a shoulder injury, and I came back and I started my shoulders again. I started really light. I sat on the edge of the bench looking in the mirror, 5-pound dumbbells, and I tried to figure out different angles, different hand positions, different humerus positions that would stimulate firing of the medial head, the front head, posterior head of the delt, and different angles. And I realized from different angles, you stimulate the muscle to fire, it's gonna grow, it's gonna respond. So that's why I do a lot more angles, a lot more volume, pumping the blood, really focusing on the feel, on the swell, on the volume. Heavy, yeah, but heavy with control. Maybe, anyway, you know, my shoulders are not very dominant body part from my body, so it's not like they're super powerhouse. My chest, I can beat the hell out of it heavy-wise, but same thing with my quads, but shoulders, a little bit more finesse, a lot more volume, and I found they've responded really well. So that's something for you guys to try when you're looking at building shoulders. More volume, more feel, more squeeze. No matter what body part you're training anyway, it's all about the connectivity. The more your brain can connect to the muscle fibers, control the firing until the muscle fiber is exhausted, that's when it's gonna stimulate growth. Like this is fun. This is improvising. It's a calf machine, but it works really good for shoulders. What we're gonna do is allow the elbows to flare out a little bit. So hit the medial head. Leaning forward in the beginning of the movement, we'll target the anterior head of the delt. Then as you push through and lean into it, you're gonna get a real nice, especially now I got some fatigue and some blood in the rear head, you're gonna get some real nice activation of the rear head of the delt as I lean into the movement at the end. I love these as a burnout at the end. Always good. Always fun.